Hey everyone, my name's Nick. Welcome back to Instinct RC. So in this video, we're gonna be taking a bit of an initial preview look at a new product that's just hit the market for our RC cars. And it's made by these guys, Soda RC. So let's get into it. All right, so just before we get into this video, quick disclaimer, I'm still very much an intermediate driver and I'm still learning a lot of things about these cars. I'm still learning many of the basics of tuning. I've got a pretty good idea now, but it's still very much a learning process and I'm early on in that process. There's just so much tuning adjustability on these cars. I mean, you have a look at them. You've got your rear pills, you've got your inner links, you've got sway bars, diffs, you've got shims on the diffs and things like that. You've got your outer hubs, you've got the same on the front, and you've got the shocks, obviously. You know, there's just so much adjustability on these cars that it's quite overwhelming. Like sway bars and the center diff and stuff as well. And that doesn't even go into like pinions and things like that. And this is an electric, it's not even a nitro. So I'm still learning more and more every time I go out there. I've got a good idea of setting up for mainly high grip. Low grip is still, I haven't had enough experience with that, but I've got a bit of an idea. Yeah, there's just so much tuning available on these cars as they are that I didn't want to pull the trigger on this until I felt like I was ready. And after the state titles, I thought to myself, well, I'm probably at a point where I can really start making some good progress past that sort of intermediate stage. And I'm getting a good, you know, understanding and feeling of how the car reacts and how setup changes affect the car while it's driving. So I thought I might as well give these a go, see how they feel and how they, you know, make the car feel and if they can, you know, make me a better driver. Because essentially these are supposed to be the evolution of what we currently use in our RC cars. And essentially all it is right here. So that is a shock shaft and a piston. So you've got the shock shaft, which moves up inside the shock body, and that just moves up and down. And you've got the piston on top, which basically controls how the oil inside the shock moves. It basically controls the speed, the velocity, and how much. So you've got, in this one, this is an 8x1.2, I believe. So you've got 8 holes of 1.2 millimeters each in diameter, I believe. And as the piston moves up and down the shock, the oil moves through this and this controls ultimately how the shock feels and, you know, how slow or fast it is. So you can adjust how the shock feels using these pistons. There's a variety, there's so many third-party options out there. There's angled ones, there's one with shims, there's one with valves on the pistons. There's so many. But from my understanding, the basic principle that you can't get around with this sort of shock design and suspension design is you only have one piston and it doesn't matter where sort of inside the shock body it is, it's still going to react the same way. Yes, you can have sort of valved pistons which can, you know, change how it works up and down, but it's not going to change how the piston actually reacts at different points in the range, if you want to call it. So, you know, if it's at the top or bottom, it will sort of act the same because at the end of the day, nothing is changing with the piston. So what these are supposed to do is allow for position sensitive dampening, which if you have a look at here, I haven't actually unboxed these yet, but you can see that they've got three different sections, if you call them. And you can actually see that there's an insert there, there's no insert in that one, and then there's another insert there, and they're obviously colored. And essentially, that allows you to tune in those three sections how the dampers feel as the shock shaft moves through those sections. So essentially, instead of just having a single shock body and a single shock piston, and as the piston moves through, you know, you can only control how it feels across the whole range, you've essentially got three positions which you can control this in. So it's supposed to be an evolution of what these are, which is like over 100 years old apparently. So that's what it's supposed to do. It just basically provides you a much bigger tuning window. So yeah, let's get these open, let's have a look, and then we'll get them installed and we'll see how they go. Okay, nice little happy family. So these are the sleeves themselves, and then we also have the inserts as well here. So you can see that these are very, very small inserts, if I can get it to focus. So you can see how small they are. And these have different, essentially, feels. So Soda RC has heaps of guides and charts on his website, on the website, as to how each of these inserts relate to their piston type. So essentially each of these inserts will give you the feel of a respective piston. So this is a set of prototype inserts he sent me. So you can see the red is a 1.41 millimeter, the white a 1.3 millimeter, blue 1.2, yellow 1.1, and purple 1.0. I'm not sure if that's actually relating to the inserts themselves, like the width or the thickness of the insert. But essentially, on the website, it gives you a chart of what piston it feels like. So I've got the chart here from the website. I'll link everything down in the description. So you can see there, that's essentially what each insert feels like. This doesn't include the prototypes, but you can see that it has the purple and the blue and the red, which are the standard ones. So insert feels like these standard pistons. So the red insert, for example, feels like an 8.1.2 angled. It also gives you a comparison of this insert versus, you know, the previous one. So essentially the red is the firmest insert, so it'll give you the most dampening. The blue is the second, and the purple gives you the least. And then obviously you can see minus 35% in terms of damping, comparing the purple insert to no insert. But yeah, that's a great chart on how to set these up. I'm not going to do an installation video or anything here. Matt's done a great one on his YouTube channel, which I'll link below as well. So I'm just gonna go ahead and install these inserts. I've got a setup, which I got from Matt, for our high grip track at Southern Districts, which is high grip oiled clay. I'm gonna put that on and we'll come back once I've set that up. All right, we're back. So that took me a little longer than expected. Probably took me about 30, 40 minutes after fiddling around with these, especially the grub screws. So you can see there, those grub screws are tiny. Those are 2.5 mil, I believe. So you can see there, and that's a very, very small Allen wrench. It's probably like a 0.7 or so, maybe smaller. So yeah. They're a bit fiddly, but I've got them all together. So I'll just show the shock shaft here. So you can see there that that's got the shim and the washer and the nut on top. There's a 4 mil grub on the side, which he installs in the video. That's obviously used partly to keep the shim positioned there. And then if I flip this over, you can see there that on the back, on the rear sort of there, I've got two grub screws next to each other. So you've got two 2.5 mil grub screws and that 4 mil on the side. From watching the video, those grub screws basically allow you to control the rebound. And from what he was saying, you'll have 30% more rebound with none of the grub screws in there. That's obviously better for jumps and high grip and things like that. So I'm curious to see how this will work. Yeah, so I'm running a setup which Matt recommended me. So on the fronts, we've gone with red, blue, red there, you can see. Sorry, that'll be the top there. So the reds will be, when it's fully compressed, it'll be very stiff, a lot of dampening going on. And then in that middle range, it'll be similar to like a 8x1.2, which is, you know, the standard for these, the S3540 Evo standard piston that I run. So in that range, it'll be similar feel. And then at the other end, when the shock is fully extended, you'll be in that red range again, really thick dampening. And then I was recommended to, with the rear, from bottom to top, red, yellow, blue. Similar to the front, a little bit different. The yellow is the prototypes. Looks to be a little bit less dampening than the blue. Yeah, red's the stiffest or thickest amount of dampening. The blue is the next behind it. So red's 50%, blue's 20. And then I'm not sure what the yellow is. He hasn't got that on the chart yet, but I'm guessing like maybe 10% or something like that. Yeah, so that's what he's recommended. Again, this is all very new to me. I don't really know what to expect. I'm not an engineer. I'm not an expert when it comes to fluid dynamics, physics, and things like that. Obviously the physics in these RC cars are very different to what we see in our normal, you know, everyday vehicles. There's a lot of engineering here, but I'm not going to dive too much into that side of it. It's more so Matt at Soto RC and whoever else has been involved has engineered these products. And yeah, it's up to us to try them out and see how they feel and tune them, I guess. We've got all these tuning options now. We can you know, give it a go. These inserts, they're pretty easy to put in. I think that one's not quite in. I'm just gonna pop that in. So it pops in and sort of clicks into place, and then they just sit in there nicely. Very easy to pop them in. And when it comes to tuning out in the field, I'd imagine you can just pop the sleeve out and then change your inserts and pop this back in. And yeah, you'll just have to quickly do maybe a top up of oil and maybe a quick bleeding of the shock, and you're good to go. Yeah, I don't think there's any other concerns. The grub screws in this were pretty, a little bit fiddly because they're so small, but yeah, they all went on pretty well. And yeah, like I said, I wasn't going to record a full-on installation video because Matt's already got that on his channel, but if there is demand for that, I'm happy to. Yeah, Matt's done his installation video and it's perfectly good. This is his product, he knows how to do it. I just follow his. This is the standard hex cell bladder that we use in the shocks. And this is the new one. So this is the Soto RC bladder. This is not made of silicon. This is made of another material. It's a lot more durable apparently because silicon swells up with oil and stuff, and apparently it doesn't hold up to the forces that these shocks undergo. So I'm going to get these installed into the shock bodies, bleed them, do everything, and we'll get them on the car, and yeah, we'll test them out on the track and we'll see how they go. All right, so just a quick follow-up to this video on the Soto RC shocks. Thanks to the weather, there's been quite a bit of rain. Hasn't been appropriate to properly try these out, but I've got them in and I just sort of give a like first initial impressions. Like, these feel really, really good. Like, they feel super stiff. Like, incredibly, like, even at the bottom, they pack right up at the bottom, and it's actually pretty hard to bottom these out on the actual chassis. So I'm very curious to see how these go. I reckon that they already feel like a pretty big improvement over the standard shocks and pistons. They feel good. Alrighty, so yeah, that was that. It was pretty straightforward, although yeah, it took me a lot longer than expected. So yeah, I'm just gonna, like I said, chuck these in the shocks, bleed them, and we'll see how they go. I'm very curious to see, yeah, how they feel and get tuning, I guess. Hopefully I can hit the track a lot more and yeah, we can play with these a lot more. So just another tuning option to add to the limitless tuning options already available for these cars. So we'll see. As an intermediate driver, I thought it would be more interesting and more useful to more people to see how these would actually, yeah, how they would play into my driving and how they might help me be a better driver, and also just how I will feel the differences on the track, because obviously there's a big jump between me and a top level driver, or, you know, even a professional level driver. So yeah, I think there's a lot more people sort of around my sort of skill level. Hopefully getting my perspective on it will be useful and helpful to a lot of people. So thank you very much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. Stick around, plenty more content to come. Yeah, if you like the video, give it a like, you know, share it around. Yeah, appreciate all the support so far. We'll keep going with this, keep improving with my setup and everything, and you know, with my little studio here, keep trying to make high quality videos. Good luck to everyone with the upcoming ABC Philippine Masters, I believe. And yeah, next video, we'll see you guys out on the track.